sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. He's just one of those guys that if the game's on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
Reload! Check it! 220! Why protect?
Like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show them how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, put a, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like, I know. Hold up, what you mean, where you been in? This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? A box under the bridge, like Anthony Kiedis, looking for something to complete us. And maybe lead us. A long way from equalist, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed. Everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed. Everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know. I've been knocking door down like a witness. God is my witness, I'm witness. But on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 17, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the venom master. It's like the devil playing spades with the pastor.
But he was born with the privilege.
Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. And some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great granddaddy didn't take a pickle to the back. Not accepted by the bottom, ghetto. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people. Everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed. Everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know. Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Seem like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act.
Yeah. Young Gerald. Yeah. Die line
with the boom pow. Every week now I switch to a new style. I'm in the mood now. 2 a.m. What you wanna do now?
What you wanna do now?
Lil baby pass. Don't spill on me, that's Margiela. Got this Oakland game to tell her. She look familiar. At Coachella, what's her name? Isabella. Forget it, yeah. Like a week ago, but we both know how weekends go. Tryna function, got some places we could go. Lot y'all got me speaking slow like, yeah. I'm blessed. I don't GA. You tryna. Yes. Say less. You ain't go. Say less. Yeah. Yeah, was like a week ago, but we both
off, know how weekends go. Tryna tuck off, got some places we could go. Swear she got the d- like, wow, she's blessed, I'm blessed. I don't G-A, you tryna, yes on, yes on, yes on, yes.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today, there's going to be a pair of wide receivers looking to make big plays on the field. It's Hopkins, it's Texans going up against Adams' Packers. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL, there's a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with the Houston Texans. And we say hi again, one and all. Brandon Godden here as we count you down to kickoff. And I turn to my partner, that's Charles Davis. And Charles, I know even a former defensive back like you can admire some of the receivers in the game today. And Larry showed us a couple that are very likely to stand out in this one.
Yeah, and it's hard for me to admit that I actually admire receivers. But with their acrobatics, with their speed, with their moxie, and the way they go up and get the football, they can change the outcome of a game in an instant.
Mason Crosby of the Packers has it teed up, and off we go from Lambeau. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Staff's doing a good job upstairs. They'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
On second down, here's Watson. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine.
Let's go.
Watson now to throw. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Muhammad Wilkerson in there to get him for a loss of three, and it'll be fourth down.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
It's taken to the 26. 51 yards on the punt there. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. And 10. Here's Rodgers. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
From the gun on third down, Rodgers. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Zach Cunningham coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down. They do go for it. It's Rodgers. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. It's caught at the 10. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal.
Well, we know that someone has absolutely no fear. Fourth down, they throw it downfield. That ball was competed for by both the defender and the guy catching it, and he comes down with it. Now they've got first and goal. What a big-time play.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu, and he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Charles, let's step into a conversation about Houston in 2017 as their offense comes back onto the field here. But just 1-9 in their last 10 games, finished 4-12. You and I know, though, injuries really ravaged this team.
Absolutely destroyed this team. And look, we focus on Deshaun Watson, the quarterback, and rightly so. He was probably going to be the rookie of the year. But when it started for injuries, it was defense. J.J. Watt. Perennial All-Pro goes out early. Whitney Mercilus, double-digit sack guy out. Brian Cushing, starting linebacker out. When you start totaling up the injuries they had through the year, it's almost amazing that they made it through the entire season able to play the schedule. So that's what you're looking at with the Texans, who have been a defense-first team. If they can get everyone back healthy playing to their level and get Deshaun Watson back sparking the offense, optimism will be high in 2018.
Watson on first down. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, 53 yards. And the Texans have taken the early lead. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And the Texans take a 7-0 lead. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis, some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins. And about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks, DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names that could be out there as free agents. Now the first carry for Ty Montgomery. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Team!
Rodgers to throw on second down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he will be hit with a lot of force and spun down. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Here's Rodgers to throw. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Two seconds to go, first quarter. To the air on second down. It's Rodgers eluding the pressure right, and he checks this one down to Williams. One quarter down. It's a close game here early on. We're back to Lambeau in just a moment. First down carry, it's Williams. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. It's caught on the right side, Williams. It'll be a gain of 6, and they're going to face a third down. Working from the gun, Rodgers escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. What can't Aaron Rodgers do? The legwork there getting him to first.
These type of plays are backbreakers for our defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. Flush to his right. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jonathan Joseph. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. He's got room to run past the 20. And he'll cut it to the right sideline. Lamar Miller, 30, 20, 10, touchdown, Houston. Lamar Miller, 93 yards. And the Texans are able to show off their quick strike ability. Well, from back where that one started, they were hoping probably for just a few yards on the ground there. Instead, they get 90-plus and into the end zone.
And as much credit as I have to give the guys on offense, I often think when I see a run of that magnitude that there has to have been a mistake made, maybe even multiple mistakes on defense, because you're expecting them to run the ball in that stage of the, from that stage of the field. Instead, it turns into one of the longest runs that we're going to see in the NFL.
Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Oh, look at that. Oh, now he pulls him over. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for Hurricane Relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Flushed out right. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
On now is the Packers punter. Back deep, Bruce Ellington. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. So the football switching hands here in just a second. And, you know, Tom Brady, just to go off on a tangent for a second, may have lost the Super Bowl. But third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last nine NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl that same season, 0-9.
Yeah.
Yeah, go all the way back to Kurt Warner in, what, 1999, where he won the double?
We were going over that stat earlier. That is hard to believe.
But he would have been the MVP had the Patriots pulled that one out.
Yeah, he still has five rings, though, five Super Bowl titles for Brady. First down throw, Watson. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
For the Green Bay Packers, they're coming off a 7-9 season as their offense makes their way back onto the field. But with that 7-9 season, Charlie, saw their string of eight straight playoff appearances come to an end. It was just weird not to have Green Bay in the playoffs, right?
Yeah, you kept searching for them, didn't you? You kept looking down the list. When does Green Bay play in the playoffs? Because you're so used to it. But with the injury to Aaron Rodgers that knocked him out for so long, the offense really struggled, finished 26th in the league in total offense. In a lot of ways, remarkable they finished 7-9.
Yeah, and Brett Hundley came in, tried to do his thing. I don't think it was much of an indictment on the play of Hundley, as it made me appreciate Aaron Rodgers more.
I think we all did, and I do believe that the head coach, Mike McCarthy, was trying to fashion offense and also take care of Brett Hundley in the beginning, and that made things easier for opposing defenses.
Caught left side by Cobb, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Rodgers to Cobb, good for a Green Bay first. They go play action here on first down. And left side here, it's Graham. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. When halftime rolls around in just a bit, we'll send you to Orlando. You will hear the dulcet tones of Mr. Larry Ridley with our EA Sports halftime report.
Does dulcet mean good?
Yeah, it's just something the broadcasters say. It's got to be good, right? You tell me.
Well, it's got to be good if Larry's doing it.
It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Rodgers gives this to Jamal Williams. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard at the 4-yard line.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Christian Covington coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them, because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. So we have reached halftime here. It's the visitors, the Texans, out in front, as we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry?
All right, Brandon, back to you guys in a minute. But first, it's indeed time for our EA Sports halftime report. The Packers are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost. The Texans have come in and looked good as the road team, and will just keep trying to play hard and maintain the lead going forward. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Now first and 10, under duress, and the pass is picked off. Matthews reading the play and comes away with it, ending the drive. Offense on the field now after the pick. Watson's got the completion through the middle. This play goes for a score as they get out to a 7-0 lead. We go to the second quarter. The pass ends up being picked off. Josephs is the one who makes the pick, halting the offense's drive. Offense on the field now after the INT. Miller's got great blocking here, and he'll win the sprint to the end zone. The lead now at 14.
All right, Larry, these two teams back out there as we get set and ready for this second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. 7 yards, the pickoff on the pitch and catch. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Andy's getting the ball here. Andy's getting the ball.
the gun. It's Rodgers. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It's the Wisconsin native and former Badger, J.J. Watt. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on 3rd and long. They go play action for Montgomery, and now Rodgers eluding the pressure right. And that's caught at the 25. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Fresh set of downs here. To throw, it's Rodgers. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A big hit. Knocked down sideways at the 9-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Now a play fake here on first down. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Andre Howe. And look out. I think he's going to go. The 40. He's at the 30. And they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too. This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23. It'll be a gain of 7, and they get it back to a 3rd and 3. Rodgers now to throw. And able to find Graham. Complete. He gets 7 out of it, and he also gets a first. Now it's Rodgers. Buying time to his left. Lets this one rip toward Graham. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
An attempt at a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. Now Williams, and I think we've got a hold here. It's a 5-yard pickup for the moment. Let's see what our referee says.
Holding offense.
That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
On second down, here's Rodgers. Steps away to his left. And he's going to drop this off to Williams. Complete. Give him six on the play. And it's going to be third down and a ways to go here. Third and 14. Rodgers again now. He's got a man. It's his fullback. They needed 14. They got 15 here on third down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes that's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Rodgers now on first down. Throw left side, complete. It's Graham. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Being chased out left. Completes it left side to the tight end, Lewis. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
He lost 2 there, and it's third down. Rodgers looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Forced out to his left, and he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for 6 and a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Rodgers now on first down. Dancing to his left. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off here by Aaron Colvin. He's at the 40. The 20. 10. 5. And they will score a pick 6 for the Texans TD.
Now, that was a beautiful play, a pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
Well, you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
Now the try here for the point after. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field and following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Collision there, jarred the ball loose, and brings up 2nd down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Rodgers again here on second and 10. Buying time to his left. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he's got his man on the out route. Now he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So the offense has it 1st and 10.
Single, single, slot, slot. Hey, you're on an island over there.
Rodgers to throw once more. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Cobb. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. On play action, Rodgers. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. So they took a shot on 1st down, but couldn't connect. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Rodgers going to throw. And now here is another interception. Zach Cunningham with a pick. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Second down, here's Miller. And now running right through him. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves them with a 4th down now. NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on 4th down conversions. This is a bit tougher. 4th and 4. They will indeed snap it to Watson. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. Well, they get a 4th quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. From midfield, here's Rodgers. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Graham. It's a big play that time for the Packers. 42 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That was very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Escaping the pressure right. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the five. He's at the 50. The 30. Past the 20. And it's a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on...